two very cautious men, not looking to overcommit, not looking to get into early trouble.
Lushitani did take the middle a lot faster than he did in the first round, and he looks like he is going to go stay busier.
Punished for it there momentarily.
Oh, and another kick up high.
That same right ear. Back to the form of the first round with Rushitani on the outside.
And if you look at all the strikes thrown this far, Moraes 24, Arushitani 18.
I'd love to see the stats for punches connected, though. A great deal smaller than those numbers, I fancy.
And beating the heck out of the air. And if you look at Moraes there, 5 of his punches landed. Yushitani, 9. No real damage done so far. A couple of leg kicks connected, and bam, right up the center. Moraes is starting to find his target.
It's probably the leg kicks, Jason, that will give Yushitani the edge in the judges' views so far, just because there's been so little action elsewhere.
You know, there's a couple of camps out there that put together really good game plans that are predicated on just backpedaling and picking your points and picking your shots, but it's a different scoring system than we have here in 1FC. You're just looking to win rounds and go, look, I backpedaled the whole time, but I landed 6 punches.
Guys,
oh, I think we might get a warning from the referee here. I think this is very good. He's giving them a warning, so you got to have more action. You have to engage.
Engage, fellas. That's what he said, basically.
Now, if we see a yellow card come out, that means that 10% of the purses from both fighters go back to the house.
That'd hurry you up a little.
Yes, it will. There you go. And Moraes in nice in on a single leg. Yushitani's got that overhand whizzer, peppering with some punches.
Let's go, guys. Let's go. Fight!
Little exchange. You know, it's very frustrating, too, that if you want to engage with your fighter and you spend the whole time chasing him backwards, you kind of have to play possum a little bit. I like what Moraes did there. He might start moving backwards and say, look, if you want to move backwards, you got to come towards me and then get him inside of your range.
I think Moraes may be bleeding from the nose. I thought that in the first round, actually. He's dabbing at his nose. May have some breathing difficulty there. May have damaged it.
I mean, Yushitani really hasn't put together anything outside of a couple of high head kicks. He's just kind of thrown 1 and 2. He hasn't really put together combinations. I'd like to see him work inside or look for something. See, that just like that, kind of throwing 1 punch or 1 kick and then backing outside. Oh, and then there you go. Nice right hand over the top. You know, the pacing of this fight, you got a couple of punches being thrown. 1, 2. There's a nice takedown, good double leg. We'll see if Moraes can really exploit some of his Brazilian jiu-jitsu training here.
He's on one leg and one hand.
Oh, that was smart.
Now, here we go.
Oh, he's on his back. This is going to be the end. He's in deep on that choke.
It's out.
Done.
He's tapped and it's over. And for a contest that really saw very little action, it was over in fairly explosive fashion. Final 5 minutes.
You know, one of the things to look at too is that Suzuki has had all of his fights in Shudo, and they judge by a different system than we do here in 1FC. So I wonder if, you know, you just get so ingrained into, okay, I have to do this to win a fight. You're not thinking about the fact that it's not judged by rounds. You actually got to go in there and create some damage. You need to look for that knockout. You know, there's been a couple close submissions. I wouldn't really say it was super near. You know, maybe 1 or 2 with that that head and arm triangle attempt. And another just great double flare. This is like watching the first round all over again. Double leg flare. Right into that Kimura attempt. Well, Adriano Moraes is showing everybody why he is considered one of the top prospects in the world. Because Kosuke Suzuki is a tough, tough, tough opponent. We talked about already. He's a former 123-pound Shudo rookie champion on a 5-fight win streak. And it almost looks like, you know, Moraes is just dominating this fight. Back in on that head and arm attempt.
3.5 minutes left in this contest then.
Oh, this is it. This is that head and arm triangle choke. Oh, you saw there, he almost thought about tapping. It's closed. There it is, it's
there
over.
It is.
This is the man that's gonna be fighting for the title against Jay Hay and Stockwheel.
Ready, fight!
Eugene Toquero, if he was to win this, it would be something of an upset, but he's more than capable of providing that.
Eugene Toquero fighting out of that left stance. He jumps in with a big left hand there, throws caution to the wind, and really tangles up with Adriano Moraes. That's a risky shot right there because he knows his strength is going to be on the, in the feet. But he throws him off, ends up in the top position, lands some big elbows there.
We expect Moraes to be in charge when it gets down to the deck. Toquero is well prepared. Kind of bounced off Moraes there with that kick. Actually went back a few steps himself after having unleashed.
As Toquero threw that low kick, Adriano caught it and put him onto the ground. And this is where Adriano Moraes really excels. He just transitions so beautifully from position to position. He's pushing that head down, dropping some punches there.
Ooh, looking to land that heel in the face. Could be a very damaging blow. Good left hand from Toquero. Moraes won't like that as he tries to move to gain an advantage in his position. Flying knee from the Filipino. Moraes goes down, but holds on to that single leg.
Oh! I think he hurt him with those punches.
He certainly did because he staggered backwards and into the cage. Got up quickly, probably a little too quickly for his own good.
Toquero's got to create space and get away.
Somebody's cut, there's some blood somewhere. I think it's coming from Moraes.
Moraes was wobbled and he got hit with that big knee. He was getting hit with those big strikes. He's in a north-south choke here.
He may need to do something quickly if that cut is big. There's a lot of blood that suddenly appeared.
Oh, he is
right above the red, the right eye, and it's swollen up as well. Toquero wants the referee to look at it. It doesn't necessarily need to take Toquero's request to do that, but Olivier Cost, off his own back, has decided to do that himself.
Wow,
in comes the doctor.
Steve, that was impressive. Eugene Toquero rocked Adriano Moraes with some big shots from the guard on his back. As Adriano was backing up, Toquero flies in. You can see him wobble just a little bit there, and there's that brutal left
knee. That's the knee that would have cut him, I think.
By Toquero, and Toquero just starts landing some big shots. You can see Adriano is wobbled as he very, very intelligently goes to the takedown, secures the takedown, and just tries to recompose himself.
Here's what's at stake. If Moraes loses this one, be it on a stoppage via cuts or any other way, it's a big, big loss for Moraes, who is cut, I can see, on the bridge of the nose there, as well as that awful-looking swelling above the right eye. A win for Toquero would absolutely catapult him to the top of the charts, and a title tilt would be in his extremely near future. Tries to go out with the big left hand and catch Moraes by surprise. Toquero has the bit between his teeth.
He sees that's a huge target right now, right there on that, over that right eye of Moraes.
This is what knees can do. They can be so damaging, such a heavy blow. And they land in a big area as well.
But Steve, talk about the toughness of Adriano Moraes to absorb all that punishment, to get wobbled. It looked like he was wobbled at least three times during that exchange, and to still come back. Catches the kick there. He's pointing to the eye there of him. I wonder if that's a little bit of gamesmanship,
yeah,
a little bit of
it
taunting.
Could well be. He's more than capable of that, Toquero. He's got a lot of charisma and he'll use every little ounce of it to his advantage. Oh, there was an accidental clash of heads there that I imagine would have done Moraes any good, although he was perhaps more at fault.
that's a big takedown from Moraes as he just steps over into the half guard now. He's possibly looking to set up maybe a Kimura. A little bit of elbows right there as Moraes just kind of controlling from the side control position. Knees are legal to the downed opponent in this position, yep. So he can lead to the knee to the head in one championship.
Certainly did that as well. There it is again. Watch that right knee of the Brazilian.
So you can just see the control that Adriano has. He has one arm, his right arm near the head, and the left arm kind of blocks the hips. And now we see how he transitions back to the other one. That just helps distribute his weight better and helps him allow to keep control of Toquero. But Toquero got back into half guard, but he's still flat onto the mat. He really has to try to move onto his side to create some kind of movement.
Takes a couple of heavy forearms to the bridge of the nose, the Filipino.
Very smart by Adriano Moraes to slow this down and just kind of regain his composure after getting wobbled three times in this opening round. Here's a possible... That could be a choke here. Looks like he might have a Darce choke. It looked like it might be an anaconda. Yeah,
the arm's in there. Not
see,
much movement from
Toquero.
Oh, he's come from behind, hasn't he?
Fight!
Still got a nice bounce in his step. Moraes ready to unleash some of this newly found boxing he's been working over at American Top Team in Florida. Nice little inside leg kick there. He attacked the lower leg, which is kind of a new thing where they're attacking the calves and the shin with that leg kick, and it really, really is a painful shot. If you ever bumped your shin on top of the coffee table,
yeah,
it's just that little bit of a pain. But imagine that times 4,600. That's basically what it feels like when somebody tries to take that leg out from under you. Steps over nicely into half guard. Again, he's applying that pressure with that shoulder. A little bit of ground and pound there. Open-handed strikes. Just kind of like when you smack somebody on the ear like that, it just disorients you. He's in mount now. Gives up his back. Oh, nice scramble initiated there by Batroff.
And then he goes chasing Moraes. Flying knee, catches Moraes. Oh,
beautiful. Did you see that escape, Steve? As Batroff tried to jump into the guillotine, Moraes jumped up too to avoid Batroff being able to wrap his legs around it.
They were both flying at one stage.
They jumped up into the air and landed on the canvas. But that was a very highly skilled technique, not just a flop down to the ground. Here he is back into side control. And again, he's got that headlock there, and he's given up possibly again one of those chokes.
Action! Press. Come to finish.
Might want to let that head go and start moving away as he tries to escape out the other way.
You keep calling for action, which at that stage seemed a little bit unfair because they were both trying to make a move.
Batroff was trying to get away. He was trying to get out of the side control there, but Adriano just not letting him go anywhere. See, this is that cage control that we had earlier in the stat.
He's okay.
You know, we can just see that, you know, Adriano is able to manipulate and control his opponents almost at will with that high level BJJ.
Knees to the top of the head, being careful not to land on the back of the head, which would be an illegal blow, but the top's okay there.
Shoulders.
Yeah, he's going for the shoulder, isn't he? You're right with the knee.
I like the awkward attacks. You know, when you're in this north-south position, you can really deliver a lot of these different type of strikes that your opponent's not used to. Start kneeing in their shoulder. You know, there's a north-south choke.
Now that choke, look, Yuji's asking.
He's okay.
Yuji's excited about it. He's looking to see if there's a tap coming.
There is a north-south there. He's possibly squirming out of it. He's not going to give into that. Nice, toughs his way out of that. Batroff is tough. That choke might have been in there pretty deep, especially when they still don't look that wet, like they're not that slippery. For him to squirm out of that was an impressive feat of strength.
150 left in the second round. This is a 5-round contest for the interim flyweight belt.
So that's what he needs to do when he starts getting into these dominant positions. Drop elbows, hurt him when he's got him in an advantageous position. Adriano's definitely winning the ground fight here. He's not really doing a lot of damage. Now he is. See, now he's starting to drop those elbows. Bartov's got to create something new. He's got to get out of the bottom position here. He's trying to lock in that arm so he could throw his arms up for a possible submission. You know, working off the back like this.
Big right hand, wasn't it, from Adriano? So obviously quite impervious to it.
See, trying to use that hip bump sweeper, trying to sweep him over, but it's just so hard when you get a BJJ practitioner, the skill of Adriano. And trying these, you know, these are basic sweeps that he's trying here, and he's just not working. He steps over into mount. See how he's trying to bridge away. He might give up his back. That's not where you want to be with Adriano Moraes. He's pushing the hips away to create a little bit of space. That's good.
But he's taking punishment, although they're glancing blows. So many of these punches landing flush on the face. And there's the possible RNC. He's right underneath. There's 16 seconds left in the round.
That's deep. That's deep. He's got it.
He's tapped out.
Contest brought to you by Predator Gaming. Summon your inner strength.
The moment has arrived. How will Danny Kingad handle the pressure of being in a five-round world championship match? We know that Moraes has been in there with some of the very best time and time again. He knows what it's like to defend the title, to lose the title, and to win the title.
Who will be the predator? Who will be the prey? I'm feeling our process at the moment. The opening 30 seconds. Big outside thigh kick there from Danny Kingad.
We expect Moraes to play the stand-up with him, to really start to see how Danny Kingad reacts in all these situations. Once he figures out the stand-up, look for Moraes to get this match to the ground.
Kingad had an extensive 8-week camp. The champion, Moraes, a 6-week camp at American Top Team. Moraes said yesterday, I've got to be careful of the wushu style of Kingad. Kingad wants to stay in boxing range, unload the hands. He knows on the ground he's going to be careful because the skill set of Moraes is superb. Fakes the cross there, does Danny Kingad. Moraes jabbing. Such a phenomenal all-around performance to capture the title against Akhmatov in Macau in August. And if Kingad wins tonight, this place will go into a frenzy that won't stop. Outside leg kick again there from Danny Kingad. Can you imagine if one championship has three Filipino world champions, Vera, Flying, Kingad?
You see him just sort of figuring each other out right now. Lots of respect shown by both these martial artists. They're just kind of seeing how each other reacts. When I throw a leg kick, what do? When I throw the jab, how are you reacting to it?
Moraes almost catching that roundhouse kick from Kingad. Kingad's got to be careful. Don't leave the limbs hanging out there. Moraes will tie you up. He'll take you down. Then it becomes the Phenom's world.
But they're just naked leg kicks. There's nothing really setting them up. So he's not throwing any hands, he's not throwing anything after the leg kick. It's just one leg kick. So you can see Moraes start to look to catch that
kick. Half time.
We said to Kingad yesterday, Danny, are you nervous? He said, yes, of course I'm nervous, but I'm also excited. First time Kingad's ever been in a five-round contest. That said, he's not ever afraid to take Moraes to deep water. Kingad off his back now. Moraes wants to go to ground with him, and now this is where Adriano Moraes excels. What can the BJJ black belt do from here? so many options available. He goes to a very dominant side control position.
Did exactly what I was talking about. He caught the leg kick, brought the contest down to the ground. See how he's controlling that? He's kind of just setting that right leg in between the legs so he gets perfect control of the side control position here. Now he's got the head under the hand, the left hand under the arm. Good job by Kingad to get back into side control.
No tag back.
Half guard position for the champion.
Watch out.
Yeah, half guard.
No tag back. Touch here. Touch here.
Trying to keep him there. Will Moraes look to take that right leg out and pass to side control? 1 minute 20 remaining. First round. A lot of feeling out. A lot of dipping the toes in the proverbial water. But now we're on the ground. We're seeing more aggression from the champion.
This first exchange on the ground is going to tell us a lot. We're going to be able to see how Danny Kingad escapes from this bottom position, from a bad position. What do you mean? He's got 60 seconds to either survive or get back up to his feet.
Moraes now north-south position. Dangerous for Kingad. Scoots around. The Brazilian champion's going to take the back. Kingad goes turtle shell. Can Moraes get the hooks in? He's working for them. He's going to try and stretch him out. He's going to try and flatten him out. He's going to try and go for a rear naked choke.
Kingad's got to defend the left arm. He's got to defend that left arm. He's got 30 seconds. As long as he controls that left arm. Look, look at Moraes trying to sneak it under the chin.
Moraes closes the figure four around the body. That's going to affect the breathing. Here comes Moraes. Kingad in trouble. In trouble. In trouble.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.